I hope you enjoyed this presentation so far. I think you've been watching very inspirational pitch. So for me, I want to be extremely actionable and give you tons of tips on how you can acquire thousands of customers on a global scale in a year and without spending too much money. We're French, so we're a bit cheap bastard. We don't like to spend money when it comes to acquisition. So I'm gonna tell you our story and also share some tips. Just a quick question here. Who is working as a co-founder or has co-founded this startup? Can you raise your hands? Okay, who's working in marketing? Some people working in sales. All right, good, that's a good crowd. So just a little word about Lemlist, my company. So it's an email automation software that helps sales teams all over the world to get more replies to their sales prospecting email thanks to ultra-personalization. Just to give you a few numbers, in a year, we got more than 8,000 customers worldwide. We're with a very small team, it's just like 3 co-founders and 2 employees, and we're growing at 30% month over month growth. That's because we've automated tons of things, and in this presentation, I'm actually gonna share with you some tips. The first thing is why you guys should start building a community very early. Some people here are working in tech, was working in tech or has like a tech company or work for a tech company. Okay, that's not too bad. So we'll discuss also about why launching on Product Hunt when you have a product or a tech product is also really important to go on a global scale. Finally, we'll go and discuss how you can get hundreds of thousands of views on LinkedIn without spending any money. And finally, I'll show you how to put your outbound sales process on autopilot. So, when it comes to community, if you have a product or a service, the great thing is like you can leverage a community to get insights from your users, but also increase your brand loyalty and build like a strong brand and have a unique way to communicate with your users. Compared with your competitors, the fact that you have a community is also an unfair advantage because it's something that they can't really steal. And on top of that, if you have a SaaS product like we do, for us it was huge to reduce like all the support tickets. So we decided to use Facebook as the place for the community just because on Facebook, people usually hang out with friends, family, and we can communicate with them in a more chilled and decontract way. And essentially, after a year, we now have like the biggest community around email outreach that is called the Email Outreach Family. Family because we want people to feel safe. And also, like a good thing was we're able to actually build a brand and trust. We produce tons of content and valuable content to the community, which has created like a unique way for our users to share their stories, their success stories, but also give us tons of insights on our products. So here, for example, Vaibhav is working at Uber, and you know he was having issues with deliverability when it comes to sending emails. So he decided to post something in the community. We saw that you know there were a lot of interest in it. A week after, we were building a feature that generated like tons of revenue for us, and that came only because people were loyal to our brand, loyal to the fact that you know they were happy to share their insights, happy to share their problems, and we were there to listen. So the feature was built here pretty much in a week with a beta, and then we rolled it out and started like making money out of it. However, sometimes there are drawbacks with a community, is like everything is public. So for example here, you would see like at some point what we did is we decided to change entirely our product without warning our users about it. So some of them were actually really, really mad at us. As you can see, like this guy, Jonathan, this is the worst UX change I've seen in a long time. I loved Lemlist yesterday, now I can't find anything and I can't update things. So it's like, when you build a product or a company, it feels like your baby, and when someone says that, you feel like really, really sad. And we had like so many comments like this. But the good thing is like, even though when things are not going the way it should go, you can always take it to your advantage. So what we did is we answered to all, you know, like their messages. We spent time with them trying to understand their pain and needs. And after some time, you know, like we really like solved all their issue, built the right feature they were expecting and so on and so forth. And then the same guy, just after like getting our support, wrote a very like nice messages on the community, which again showed the loyalty of our customers, and we were able to build that. So that's like the first part of the community. And now we're gonna start talking about Product Hunt. Who here knows Product Hunt? Okay, so for those who don't know Product Hunt, it's the biggest tech-savvy community worldwide. Essentially, every day, people launch their product there, and there are like millions of users. It's about like 10 million traffic every month. By the way, if that interests you, like you can get the traffic of pretty much any website using this free tool. It's called SimilarWeb. It's very handy. And essentially, on this community, people will vote for the best product every day, and the best products will go in their newsletter, who has like more than a million of people. And essentially, it gives you tons of visibility, and you don't spend any money on it. However, like every launch, you need a bit to prepare it. So what we did, again, so our unfair advantage was our community. So using our community was really great for that. But also, we had a list of about like 20 different Facebook communities, so other communities than ours, where we were like really exchanges with other users, and we asked for support from there. And basically, the results for us were great. So we launched 2 times. And the first time, I mean, we ended up both time number one product of the day. And the first time we launched, we got like more than 400 signups and more than 40 paid companies, which is like pretty huge when you think that actually you're just like spending 1 day to launch, and then you get like pretty like incredible results. Now we're gonna talk about LinkedIn. Who has a LinkedIn account here? Can you raise your hands? Oh, okay. So everyone knows LinkedIn, that's cool. And I'm gonna tell you how you can get hundreds of thousands of views on LinkedIn. So far, in year like 2019, my post generated a total of more than 1 million views. And this was done by posting constantly on LinkedIn. But before we actually dive into the strategy, I just wanna say one quick thing. Even though I'm bragging about the views, let's always remember that view, likes, comments are vanity metrics, so you shouldn't focus on that. What matters really is like the number of businesses you can actually generate out of this. However, when done right, it can really be correlated. So let's have a look. First thing that you need is to build an audience. Your audience on LinkedIn is basically your connections. Since we have a lot of people signing up to our products, what I decided to do is fully automate the process. So every time signs up to Lemlist, I automatically add him on LinkedIn with a welcome message. The way it works is pretty simple. The first step is to find the actual person. So when someone signs up, we ask him to put his first name, last name, and company name. Then what we do automatically is made a research on Google, first name and last name and company name and LinkedIn. Then we pull the first results, and then we send a personalized invite, and the message is like, bonjour, first name. I say bonjour just because like the company is French. It's part of our kind of branding. And then like a message, I'd like to personally welcome you to the Lemlist family. How did you hear about Lemlist? So to do so, we used actually like, we built that automation on top of a tool that's called Phantom Buster. So you don't have to be like a developer or a coder to do that. You can do that with Phantom Buster and another tool like Zapier. So to connect this and do that automatically. And what's great with that process is first, it increases your audience. And then secondly, you can also understand where our users are coming from. If you have like a tech product or even like an e-commerce or whatever, it's always difficult to know the real source of where people are coming and where people are buying from you. So by asking, it's usually like the best way. So here, for example, we saw like that girl, she's coming from Facebook group, and this guy, word of mouth or colleagues. So now that I'm building my audience, I need to post like really good content. So when you want to post good content, the goal is not to talk about your company. As you know, like for example, we are like an email automation platform, and I know that the salesperson that uses Lemlist or the founders or like people in marketing, what they struggle the most is to get replies to their cold emails. And on top of building like really good templates for them to use, I also decided to launch a series that was called Cold Email Tips, where every week I was posting a new tip on how you could write better emails to get better. Like, so I was not selling Lemlist, I was never talking about Lemlist, I was just providing value and giving tips and actionable tips on how they can use it to really like leverage and get more replies, generate more businesses. Once I've done that, I actually use the tool that is called Lampod. So every time you, that will help you basically like boost your LinkedIn posts. So initially Lampod is, do people know here what an engagement pod is? No? Okay. So engagement pod is basically a group of persons that are willing to help each other out. So essentially it's like, maybe you've seen it in your company, it's like when someone posts on LinkedIn, they're gonna put like the LinkedIn URL on the Slack or the company messenger and say, hey guys, can you please like or comment my post so it gets more visibility. That works in companies, but when you have like very small companies, you usually do that with either friends or like potential person in your network, etc. The issue with that is it takes like tons of time and usually people are like busy at work, so they always forget to engage, etc. Lampod is great because it's like the biggest marketplace of pods and it's totally automated. So essentially what you're gonna do is join a pod, for example, if you're like a marketer or a founder, you can join a pod with founders and marketers. And once you post something, all the person in that group are gonna like your post automatically, which will generate an initial boost. And then after that, you know, like the algorithm will think that it's a really amazing post and then show it to even more people. But as you can see on my previous post here, I was around like 20,000 views. So it's a bit far from the 100,000 views I mentioned. So how do you get to that 100,000 views? It's actually when it comes to creating a viral post. I really don't like the word viral because I think it doesn't exist anymore, but still like a very, let's say, engaging post. The goal here is to ask people to do something in order to get something. If you want more views, you need more comments and more like. If you want people to do that, they need to get something out of it. So for example here, we had written like a really extensive guide on how to find anyone's email address. And I basically made a post, very simple. If you guys wanna get that guide, simply comment guides and then I'll send it to you. So here I had like more than 1,000 comments and a total of 180,000 views. And that was done, you know, like without spending any money, without doing anything like paid ads. And that generated like tons of businesses because we sent a link for people to get that ebook. They put their email in it. And after that, you know, it's like people that are potentially interested in your product, etc. And you can do that for pretty much every business. So again, initially I was saying like, yeah, number of views, it doesn't really matter. What matters is the new business you generate. And basically every time I post something, so I post at least twice a week, every time I post something, I get about like 50 to 100 people wanted to connect with me, with people like already wanted to book meetings, or people, you know, who are like just went on my profile, saw that I was working for Lemlist, went on the website, signing up, and generating like tons of business. Now that we're good on LinkedIn, I'm gonna help you how to put your outbound sales process on autopilot. So when it comes to outbound, it usually takes a lot of time to find the right person you want to contact, then finding the emails, then, you know, like sending the emails, and then you have to do that. If you've been in sales or if you're a founder and you've been doing that, it's very repetitive task, it's super annoying, and you can automate that. So the goal of this process is to, it's a multi-step process where essentially you start by finding your target on LinkedIn, especially if in your B2B, because LinkedIn has pretty much everyone on the planet. Send connection requests automatically. Then you scrape their profile and get their emails. So scrape the profile is mean like extract all the data on their profile. And finally, you send an outbound email sequence, so send email sales prospecting emails. For that, you'll need three tools: Phantom Buster, Drop Contacts, and Lemlist. I'll go into each and explain like what they're used. So the first step is finding the relevant audience. You can either use like normal LinkedIn or LinkedIn Sales Navigator in order to get like advanced filters. So try to get as precise as possible, choose the industry, choose the company size, choose the job title, etc. Then once you have that, you need to prepare your campaign. So what's different about Lemlist here is that we can generate dynamic images inside emails and dynamic videos. So for example here, the ugly gray screen is actually like a dynamic image. So every time you reach out to someone, it will pick up automatically the screenshot of his website just based with his email. So the message you send is actually ultra personalized and the person feels that the video has been made for him. When he clicks, he would just arrive on a personalized landing page, and the landing page would basically be personalized. You can add his name, you can add the company logo, you can add pretty much everything, and everything is optimized towards booking sales calls and meetings. The third step is to actually use Phantom Buster that will help you build that workflow. So what you're going to do as input, you're going to put your research URL, so the search URL when you found your target audience initially. Then you need to connect, so it's just like copy-pasting like some keys in it, and then everything will run automatically. So Phantom Buster will go, add the people automatically on LinkedIn, then send the connection request, and then when they find the email, just send it to Lemlist, and then the email sequence will just run. And for us, for example, like we launched that last week, so you know it's like it goes little by little, and that's the type of results we got, you know, with highly personalized video. Click rate, as you can see, is super high, so every time you put like a play button in an email, people love to click. So it's a great way, you know, to drive traffic towards like a landing page. And finally, like the rate of people interested was super high. You can use that not only for sales. I advise you to do it also to build your own network, meet new people. It can be used for many things. You can build like press relationship. You can build your network if you're, for example, writing content and you want to do guest blogging. And the great thing is like you can automate it with pretty much any target you want and generate awesome results. Thank you, guys. If you have any questions, I'll be, I think, in the other stage. And otherwise, you can just get in touch with me or add me on LinkedIn. I'm not sure if I didn't put my email, but anyway. Bye-bye, guys. Thank you very much.